This is the OASIS News Organization. Oh no. This will be the first trip down to Pea Cox County, Texas, to the OASIS. Now, I've spent all my life in Dallas, but I've spent a little bit of time out in the country and camping out. And I've always wanted a place out in the country. So my Uncle Fred, he was an actual traveling salesman. Well, he made a bunch of money. Well, he died and left it to his wife, who was my mother's sister. She died, she didn't spend all the money, so she left a bunch to my mother and dad. They didn't spend it all, they both died in their 90s. So I got a little bit of that. First thing I did was I looked around for that country place that I'd always wanted, and I found myself 9 acres down in Pea Cox County, Texas. It's real close to the PC Lake down there, and I started collecting a bunch of building materials off the streets of Dallas. They have bulk trash week, and I'll go around and I'll pick up lumber. Been storing away, waiting for the big day to be able to go down there. Now, of course, I didn't know what I was gonna need. So, you know, rakes and hoes and a broom, and, you know, I got a piece of sheet metal there and old bed frame. I didn't know. I'm just picking up a bunch of stuff to take it down there, because once you're down there, if you don't have it, what are you going to do? So my truck's all full there, and that white bag there actually is a golf bag from my Uncle Fred. So I figured I ought to take that down for the first trip. So I made room for it. Once I found the land, I knew for sure that it was going to be mine. They told me it was going to be a certain day. I went, cool. I started loading up the truck. Well, they put it off for 2 weeks. So that woman I lived with really, really enjoyed that truck full of mess sitting in the driveway for 2 weeks. So I'm finally all loaded up, got the little ice chest in there, and I am ready to hit the road. So the next morning, I go to closing. In that truck there, I close, and I am on the highway to Pea Cox County, Texas. It was so loaded down that I was afraid to drive on the interstate, so I took all the state highways and county roads to get to it. So it took me about 4 hours to make a 2-hour trip. That's the sound of what's in your closet. Now, this sweater I got here, it was a hand-me-down from my older brother. Now, he had it in high school, and he graduated from Bryan Adams High School in Dallas in 1966. So I got it from him, I don't know, a year or two later after that, because he went off to SMU, and of course, that wasn't a hilltop kind of sweater. And let's see, it is 2019, so I've had it for 50 years. And I wore it for a while, but, you know, I've had it all this time, and it's moved with me. And, of course, I can't wear it anymore. So what am I doing with it? And I guess you've got a bunch of those things in your closet, too. So that is a problem to work on. After my 4-hour ordeal getting down to PC County, I'm at the front of the OASIS. That nice red gate there with the automatic gate opener and that nice gravel road. Well, that's not the OASIS. The OASIS is that overgrown mess off to the left there with that brown gate. Also, when you're looking at land, if you get a gate up front, that sure is nice. Eventually, I got to have a gateway just like the other guys did in the neighborhood. That is the Arnell Boulevard. I renamed it's the driveway, but I named it after my parents, Raleigh and Llewellyn, because that's where I got the money to buy the Oasis. I've never spent much time in Pea Cox County, but just after being there a little bit, I found that things weren't the same as it was in Dallas. Look at this photograph that I took on the Oasis of a zebra kicking a lion's ass. After seeing that zebra and lion, I started looking around for other odd tracks. And look right here. Pea Cox County zombie tracks. So I called up my youngest son, Zorro. He's a part-time zombie hunter up in Dallas. And we caught ourselves an Oasis zombie. And you know, with zombies, normally you have to shoot them in the head. Well, we've found out that if you just cut them a little below their shoulders, they die too. I kept wandering around and I saw one more odd creature. That's this one's running around with his head burning. Oh, by the way, well, little wings. After seeing that creature, I ran across these two. And later on, I found out that that's Cowboy Bob, and he's the PC County pimp. And that's some old blonde that went to Cox Elementary School who evidently never got out, so he put her to work. And I talked to Bob about this, but he didn't give me a very good answer. I asked him, how come cowboy chaps, the crotch is always cut out? I've wondered about that. After all these startling revelations about the wildlife out there on the Oasis, I finally pitched my tent for that first night. Way up front there, I was finally able to pull my truck in, put up my two-man tent, and I couldn't go to sleep. And if you've never heard of mule, do mules whinny or whine or whatever they do, when they do it in the middle of the night, it sounds like somebody's being murdered. And then with all the little creepy crawly things like raccoons, armadillos, and possums, they're rummaging around. And you're all by yourself and you know that the zombies are out there too. But I finally got a little sleep that night. I learned that it's a good idea to take some sleeping pills with you. So this is a picture of the RLB and that one tree right there in the dead center. That's gonna be a problem to drive my truck up. So I had to call up Zorro, the part-time zombie hunter and part-time lumberjack. There's Zorro. He's lumberjacking away, and a few months later, he and his older brother Trinidad came down, and they cleared all the trees that were in the way on the boulevard so that the gravel truck could get in there. They did a great job. This picture here shows you got to cut your way through there. And I found out that if you see a bunch of cedar trees, it means the soil sucks. It's mostly gravel. But way far in the back of the Oasis, there's this one spot that just sold me on the place. And this is it. I just love that. You know, that's my own White Cliffs of Dover. Come to find out that that creek is full of water, it does not stay full of water. Here is the first improvement that I made at the Oasis. I had to put the Lone Star flag up. Now that's my kind of my meditation spot. Every time I leave, I go up to the flag there and I give thanks to all the different people and groups that made it possible for me to be here at the Oasis. Today's musician, Joe Walsh, his album, But Seriously Folks, the song, Life's Been Good, and the lyric, Life's Been Good to Me So Far. Remember, Onos, world peace begins at home. We'll be right back.